Yeah. Yes!
Yes, Commander.
Hey, Seth Hedrick. Lakamaya has finished his quest.
You've got the hands of a smith. Yeah. You're pathetic.
Let's get this over with.
I'm just warming up, you pathetic worm. Who? That the best you can do? I can't believe it. We survived. By the grace of the Nine, we survived. In no small part to you, Sir Knight, by your will and the will of the Nine, the Chapel of Xenathar is held against this blasphemer. Sir, I pledge my sword. I wish to join you in your quest to restore the Knights of the Nine and defeat this Umaril. I can only hope to match your bravery and valor. I am honored to serve by your side. Allow me to fetch more suitable equipment. I shall return shortly.
I can't believe it. You have the mace. And you stopped those horrible Daedra. I was wrong to doubt you. I ask your forgiveness. You too.
Sir Knight, thank Arke you are back. I have terrible news. Sir Roderick, I think he's dead. A holy knight, like you, questing for the relics at the prophet's call. I was his squire. I believed he was chosen by the gods to reclaim the relics. At first, things were going well. He prayed at all the shrines and received a vision, a disturbing vision. The shade of Sir Beric spoke to me was all he said. We must put him to rest. We traveled back and forth across Kolovia. He was always asking about an old noble family, the Vlindrels. Finally, he found what he was looking for. We went to Underpall Cave, and there he fell.
He said that Sir Beric's tomb was in Underpall Cave, which is no cave, but some kind of buried keep. He had learned that Sir Beric had once been a questing knight, like us. He had found the greaves and sword of the Crusader, but then turned to evil. Sir Roderick hoped to find the relics within Sir Beric's tomb, and he did. But we also found a terrible guardian, the wraith of Lord Vlindrel, Sir Beric.
Yes, my lord, and I brought you. Sir Roderick shouted for me to take them. The greaves, the holy relic, they're yours.
The wraith. It used it against Sir Roderick. I don't know how that evil thing could use the holy weapon, but it did. It screamed as it struck.
Sorry. I've already failed Sir Roderick once. I don't want to fail him again. I remember he said something about the sword before we... He was worried that the sword may have been turned to evil, that it may have to be reconsecrated on the altar of its creator, the divine Arche. That's all I remember. I hope it may help you. Thank you, Sir Knight. I would ask a boon if I could, although I know I do not deserve it. Would you make me a Knight of the Nine? I want to dedicate myself to ridding the world of evil. I owe it to Sir Roderick. Thank you. I mean, thank you, Sir Knight. I will not fail you. Give me a moment to arm myself, and I will accompany you to Underpall Cave to destroy the foul wraith.
Hello. I heard the gauntlet.
No idea.
Sure.
We're all talking about the Emperor's murder. We have no Emperor and no heir. That's never happened before. I suppose we should all be worried. Blessings of the Nine upon you, my friend.
Greetings, Sir Knight. The Priory has been restored to its former glory and is now a fitting home for our order. Leowyn has been attacked by Umaral's minions. Something must be done to stop him. You too.
Greetings, Sir Knight. I am at your service, Commander. Farewell.
Greetings. How may I serve you? Goodbye.
I am at your command. Of course.
Let's hear it. I hope I... You too.
For Sir Roderick!
It's the best you can do.
I am at your... Don't worry, I'll...
here! Ha!
Yeah. Yeah! Ugh!
Sir Roderick is avenged, and you have recovered the sword of the Crusader. I'll return to the Priory and give my fellow knights the good news. Farewell.
Tidings, citizen.
Thank you.
Lord Crusader, the Prophet is here. He's just arrived. He seemed to know you were coming, told me to wait for you, and here you are. Come. He is preaching to the assembled knights in the chapel. You should speak to him at once.
You have stepped from the humble shadows of obscurity and into legend. No feat you have accomplished in your life compares to what you have become. You are an embodiment of Pelennol Whitestrake, the bane of Umaril the Unfeathered. The time has come for you to fulfill your destiny. Umara lies hid in the ancient fane of Garlus Malatar. You must go there and destroy him. No. Should you face Umara, you would suffer the same fate as Pelennol. But times change, and even the shape of the divine itself must change with it. Where once there were eight, now one more stands with them, and they have become nine. I, with the apotheosis of Tiber Septim, the face of the divine was transformed. Talos ascended, and the eight became nine. So, although you wear the armor of the gods, it is incomplete. A relic of the old ways and the old gods. As a proven guardian of this realm, and a warrior the likes of which have not been seen in millennia, Talos grants you his sacred blessing. With the ancient gifts of the Eight and the new gift of the One, you are ready to face Umaril. It will allow you to follow Umaril into the spirit realm upon his death. It will allow you to destroy him, body and soul, utterly and for all time. You must first kill his living body. While beyond the power of most mortals, this is only the lesser of your two tasks. His Daedric nature allows his spirit to escape into oblivion after death. Oh, this is what Pelennor learned upon defeating Umaril the first time. But you can do what Pelennor could not. The blessings of Talos will allow you to follow Umaril's spirit when it leaves his body. This you must do, and you must not fail. You will not, because the Nine fight with you. When Umaril joined with the Daedra, his spirit expanded beyond this realm. His physical form can travel between realms, but his spirit is bound. When his body is destroyed, his spirit travels back to oblivion and is reformed in the fires of creation. With the armor of the gods and the blessing of Talos, you will be able to follow him where Pelennor could not and destroy his very spirit. Once his spirit is destroyed, he will be completely obliterated, erased from all realms of existence. Garlas Malatar was the westernmost outpost of the Aelid Empire. It watched over what we call the Abyssian Sea. Since his return, Umaril has taken Garlas Malatar as his lair. That is where you must seek him out. Umaril cannot be bested in his physical form by any normal means. His blows can strike down the mightiest of warriors in a single stroke. The Eight created the relics to withstand Umaril's fell power. Do not attempt to face him without this divine protection. Your knights will assemble at Garlas Malatar and await you there. Gather all those who you deem worthy. Not all who enter those halls shall return. Those who fall in service of the Nine will live on forever in the halls of their fathers. I wish you well on your quest, Crusader. We are depending on you.
Hail, Lord Crusader.
stand ready, Lord Crusader. Shall we launch our attack on Garlus Malatar? Of course, Commander. I think we took them by surprise.
Forge it better.
For the pass! And the nine!
Do your worst!
For Debella and Mara!
Die, Curl!
You'll never take me down!
Whoa! Do you think it's super easy?
Hit me once more! Is that the best you can do?
Amarillo, show yourself!
You're not
so bad!
No one lives forever!
We must
get the Crusader to mine to destroy the orb.
Crusader, arise, stand and face the light. Breathe again and receive your reward. You have completed your divine task. You have restored the order. You have defeated the enemy of the Nine. The order shall serve as the sword and the shield of the Nine. The dark times to come, we owe you a debt of thanks. You have succeeded where we could not. You and your knights have held true to your purpose. At long last, our purgatory is at an end. We go to the glory of the Nine to serve in their host in the life beyond this one. You may call upon our spirits when you need us. Simply pray at our tombs, and each of us will grant you a blessing from the Nine. May your sword serve the Nine all the days of your life, Crusader. You redeemed my soul from the evil that had ensnared me. For that, I am forever in your debt. The old bitterness that seemed so important to me in life. What is that now? How to weigh that against my very soul?
the sword down with me into evil. You have redeemed us both. The gods smile on such deeds, noble knight. The evil took hold of me the day that I slew Sir Caius on the priory steps. I baited him, knowing his temper, and then I killed him when he drew against me. I killed him in cold blood with the holy sword itself. I could have disarmed him or wounded him, but a cold pride had taken hold of me, and so I slew him and went to war and never returned. The evil grew upon me until I became cruel, a tyrannical ruler, a terror upon the land. In death, evil held me even tighter than in life. Thanks to you, that all is behind me. Sir Caius and I will go to Atheria side by side, as of old. The gods are truly merciful. The Knights of the Nine stand together once again. I would not have thought it possible. We owe you a great debt. May your sword strike true.
Lord Crusader, how can this be? You're alive. It's a miracle. I heard voices in the Undercroft, and I came to investigate.
You vanished in Garlus Malatar. After the battle, we searched further into the ruin and found you next to Umaril's corpse. You had no wounds on your body, but you were dead. I saw it with my own eyes. You did not draw breath. We laid you to rest in the Undercroft. We kept your death a secret. We feared what would happen if our enemies thought you were dead. I can see that. You'll have to excuse me. I need a moment to collect my thoughts. We found Umaril's body next to yours, but it seemed that you had met the same fate as Pelinor Whitestrake. We didn't know. Tell me, Umaril, what happened? Did you succeed in pursuing him into the spirit realm, as the prophet said? I never doubted you, Crusader, but I must tell the others that you're alive!
Greetings, sir. He will trouble us no more, thanks to you. The Order lives once more. Pelinol himself would be proud of what we've accomplished.
Be seeing you.
What is it, Lord? The Knights of the Nine have prevailed over Umaril. Truly, the gods have shown us favor. is no more. He and his minions are defeated, and our chapels are safe again. All hail the divine crusader. BC.
What is it, Lord?
BC.
How may I... Fair.
What is it?
Good day.
What is it, Lord? BC.
How may I serve? Good day.
Sir Knight, I come to offer myself as a knight in service of Auriel, or Akatosh, as he is known in Cyrodiil. I bring nothing but my skill with the blade, which is not inconsiderable, and my devotion to the Lord Auriel. Will you accept me, as unworthy as I am? I am honored to join the Order under your illustrious command. Excuse me while I go to the armory and attire myself as befits a Knight of the Nine.
Yeah!